Good morning, Class 6. Today we will start the chapter The Monkey and the Crocodile, which is given in your A Pact with the Sun. Before we start the chapter, I would just like to ask you, you must have read lot of stories from Panchatantra, which was written by Vishnu Sharma. The speciality of his stories were that he has made the character, like, you know, taken the characters from the animal world. They have been talking like human beings, and the best part was that every story had a moral which gave us a lesson which we can follow in our daily lives. So let's begin the story and see what lesson do we have in this one. A monkey lived in a fruit tree on the bank of a river. He made friends with a crocodile, gave him delicious fruits to eat, and sent some for his wife. They met regularly and talked. The monkey in the tree and the crocodile on the ground. So here the story is about a monkey and the crocodile. That is specified in the name of the chapter as well. So the monkey used to live on a tree which was near the bank of a river. And a crocodile lived in the river. He used to visit his friend, and monkey gave the fruits to crocodile for eating, and he gave for his wife as well. So let's see the story. Once on the bank of a river, a monkey made a home for himself in a tree laden with fruit. He lived in it happily, eating to his heart's content the fruit of his choice. The monkey was happy but lonely, and wanted a companion to talk, to share the fruits with. But there was no one around, not even another monkey. Till one day, a crocodile appeared on the riverside. So the story begins when a monkey started living near a tree, on a tree which was near the river bank. And the tree was full of, like, lot of fruits were there. And initially he was very happy because he was all alone. He could eat n number of fruits and nobody was there to share it or to stop him. But gradually what happened was he started feeling lonely because he was all alone. He had no companion to whom he could talk or with whom he could share the fruits. So he was little sad about it. But one day a crocodile appeared on the riverside. "Hello there," said the monkey. "Do you live in this river? Would you like to eat some fruit?" So monkey was happy and he asked the crocodile that, does he live in the water, in the river, and would he like to have some fruits? So the crocodile responded. "Good morning," replied the crocodile politely. "I did come here in search of food for myself and my wife. Nice of you to offer me fruit." So the crocodile replied, "Good morning, and I have come here for looking for food for myself and for my wife." And he said that he wanted to thank the monkey for offering him the fruits. So the monkey plucked some from the nearest branch and threw them down. The crocodile found them delicious. "Thanks," he said. "May I have some on my next visit?" So what the monkey did was, he plucked some fruits and he threw it towards the crocodile. The crocodile ate them and those fruits were delicious. So he thanked the monkey and he asked him that if he could come or visit him next time again. So the monkey said, "Certainly, as many as you like, and some for your wife too," said the monkey. "Do come again. I am rather lonely here." The crocodile visited the monkey regularly and ate the fruits which his host threw down. He took some home for his wife. The monkey and the crocodile were now the best of friends. They talked and were never tired of talking. They talked about birds and animals, about the villages nearby, and the difficulties villagers faced in raising good crops for lack of rain. So when the crocodile asked that if you could visit him, so monkey said, "Yes, you could come very often. As it is, I am lonely here. I am all alone. So whenever you want, you can come here." So the crocodile started visiting him regularly And when he came, the monkey gave him some fruits for eating for himself and some he gave for his wife. So the monkey, and gradually they became best of friends. They used to talk to each other like the way you people talk to your friends. You discuss a lot of things. So they also discussed a lot of things. What they discussed were, they talked about the birds, about the animals, about the villages which were nearby, and the difficulties, the problems which the villagers were facing in raising good crops because there was lack of rainfall. The crocodile's wife was annoyed because her husband came home late. She didn't like his friendship with the monkey. The crocodile couldn't altogether ignore his wife's wishes. So that is the crux of the story, of the paragraph which we are going to read. That is, the crocodile's wife got very irritated because her husband used to get delayed because he used to stay there, talk to the monkey for quite some time, and then after spending some quality time with the monkey, then he used to go home. So she was all alone by that time, and that's why she was irritated and she didn't approve the friendship which was there between the monkey and the crocodile. So one day the crocodile stayed with the monkey longer than usual. His wife was annoyed, waiting and waiting, managing the little crocodiles that had just been hatched. She said, "Who is this friend of yours you are so fond of?" So one day the crocodile, he stayed little longer than he used to stay. So his wife was very annoyed because she had to take care of the children of the young crocodiles who have just hatched. And so she said that, "Who is this friend of yours with whom you like to spend so much time?" So the crocodile replied, "Oh, he is very nice monkey," he replied. "He lived on a fruit tree. He sends fruits for you every day. You don't expect me to climb tree, do you?" So he said, "Oh yes, my friend, he's a monkey and he's very nice. He lives on the fruit tree and obviously he's sending fruits for you." He told his wife that he's sending fruits for you every day, because obviously you cannot expect a crocodile to climb the tree and get fruits. So he was little also irritated when he answered this, and he said that, "Do you expect me to, you know, climb the tree and get fruits for you?" "A nice monkey, I am sure," replied the wife with obvious sarcasm. So now here you can see the difference in the statement. The crocodile said he's a nice monkey because he wanted to tell her the quality that he was nice, he was helping him because he wanted some fruits for his wife, and that's why he called the monkey nice. But here his wife, when she said a nice monkey, she didn't mean nice in the same way. She meant nice in another way. That is, we will come to know in what sense she was saying this. "If you ask me, this monkey should be my food. I want to eat his heart so much." So that is, in that context she said, yes, he will be nice. When she will eat him, he will taste nice. That in that context she said that, yes, this monkey is a nice animal. She said that, "I want to eat his heart so much." "What a foolish thing to say," shouted the crocodile. "I can't kill a friend, though I won't mind a monkey occasionally for a change of taste." So when she said that she wants to eat his heart, initially he got very angry and he said, "How can she be so foolish? He's not going to kill his friend." But then he said, "Okay, yes, he also agreed that I will not disagree with you totally, that for a change, for the change of the taste, occasionally, once in a while, he can also have monkey in his lunch or dinner." So she said, "You bring him here," ordered the wife. "I want to see him, so you can eat him." "Never," declared her husband. So she said, she ordered her husband, and she said, "Now you go and bring him once. I just want to see him." But then her husband knew it, why she wanted. So he said, "You want me to bring him here and then you will eat him, which is not possible. I am not at all going to do this." So that's all for today, class. Please do read the chapter. We will finish off the chapter in the next class. and then we will do the question answers in the notebook. Today, the questions which I am going to give you, you will send the answers online. Thank you, class.